Action. Good.
Jordy here for Cinecom.net and welcome to Copycat Friday. This is a series where we break down an effect or technique from a popular music video or film. Now, today's episode, we'll be recreating the scribble effects from Kendrick Lamar's latest clip, Love, featuring Zachary.
Oh, got a little bit distracted there.
The nice tune that you guys are hearing right now comes from Premium Beat. They've recently launched a brand new website and a mobile app so you can start discovering music on the fly. They're also sponsoring today's episode, so thank you Premium Beat for that. Now, the new app allows you to kind of discover new music like a Tinder-like feature. They kind of throw random songs at you and you can say like or dislike on that song, and that will kind of save them in your account in a certain liked playlist, which you can also find on the website, and that way you can start creating playlists or purchase the songs that you want. Definitely make sure to check it out by following the first link in the description below. Almost a year ago, we also made a scribble effect inside Premiere Pro on a music video from Bruno Mars. So we were very excited to see Kendrick coming out with a scribble effect too. It looks completely different, it works completely different, and we decided to create it inside After Effects. But the first thing we did was the setup. The walls in our studio are painted black, so that would already work out perfect for the background. Jannik is going to sit on a bench on which we threw a black fabric over. It's important that everything in your shot is dark. Then for the lighting, we placed the aperture 120D on a dolly, and that way we can move the light just as you can see in the video clip. To make the lighting a little bit more softer, we used a dome with a single diffuser in the back. The reflection inside the dome increased the size of the light source, and the grid is helping us to aim the light better without having it spill on the surrounding. Then for the backlight, we placed a Lightstorm LED panel, also from Aperture. And to make a little contrast between the front and the back lighting, I threw a blue filter or CTB over it.
Whenever we are doing a lighting setup and we want to test out how that lighting looks, we use Justine, our stand-in right here. And this is, by the way, also Jannik's girlfriend.
That's not true.
Yes, it is.
To make it yourself easy, have your subject sit still. And now it's time to bring our shot into After Effects. We'll be going quickly over it, but if you are new to After Effects, definitely make sure to check out our in-depth beginner's tutorial, to which you can find a link to in the description below. The scribble effects are shapes, so that means we'll not be working on the clip itself. So make sure it's deselected. Then take the pen tool and draw a simple shape over the edge of your subject. By default, it will fill the shape with a red color. So you want to go into the properties of the shape layer that has just been created and delete that fill. This leaves you with a simple white line, which you can also change its white from if you like. However, I do suggest to keep it thin. And then we'll animate this line. For that, we'll need to add the trim path option to the shape layer. And you can do so by clicking on the add menu and choosing that trim paths option. And this gives you a start and end value. Animate both values from 0 to 100, but make sure that the end value starts earlier and stops earlier. This is important to see a line coming in and out. If you want to make it more dynamic, you could place some extra keyframes in between with some offset values so that the length of the line changes over time. Finally, create smooth animations by setting your first keyframes to easy ease out and your last keyframes to easy ease in. The ones in between can be set to easy ease. Just make sure you never forget to ease the easy ease out when easing the easy ease in.
A little update about the comments wall, guys. As you can see, we're making great progress. We're almost ready to start printing that wall print. Now, right here, there's going to be a heater, and we were wondering who likes his comments behind that heater. And you know what? Just say first in the comments down below, and then we know that you want your comments behind the heater.
The line animation looks good. Now it's time to add some effects to the shape. We'll start off with a glow effect, which you can find in your effects library. Play around with the settings to end up with a soft glow that doesn't spread too much. As for the glow colors, set the color A to a very bright orange and color B to white, and that will kind of add a golden color touch to the scribble. But we'll do that even more with the gradient ramp effect on the shape. Set the start color to white and the end color to that light orange again. You can then change the position of the color points so that the line gradually goes from a white to a soft orange. Next up, we'll take the edge off from the line with the roughen edges effect. You know, you don't need to change that much in here, just play around with the border and scale to have some variation in thickness of the line. Finally, we'll add the posterized time effect to it and set the frame rate to 15. This is to make sure that the scribble effect appears more like a stop motion. As the final touch, you want to change the blending mode of the shape layer to screen. To make the scribble more dynamic, you want to duplicate that shape layer, then change the path of that duplication a tiny bit, and this way you can see two lines dancing around each other. It's a bit too hectic, so what I'll do next is animate the opacity so that the duplicated line comes in and out a couple of times. The result should look like this. Next up, we want to create a reflection, which you can also see happening here in the music video. It's essentially the same, you draw a path and animate its stroke. And this time you do want to have a thicker stroke. Add the same effects to it, the glow, the ramp, roughen edges, and posterized time. The settings are pretty much similar. As an extra effect, you want to add a Gaussian blur to it and set it around 80. Finally, change the opacity to around 60, and you now have a nice looking reflection. Now this was one scribble effect. You can now copy and paste this to have it appear on multiple spots. You have to change the path or create new ones. It does consume a lot of time, but the end result is pretty awesome. We are going to dance a bit with Justine. In the meantime, you can hit that subscribe button down below to see us every Tuesday and Friday with a new exciting video. Thank you so much for watching, and as always,
stay creative.
So Janik wanted to surround himself with pretty women, just like Kendrick Lamar did in his video clip, so he came out with a pretty cool solution inside After Effects. Look at that, you almost believe this. Janik, what do you have to say about that?
Don't tell my girlfriend.
But Justine was watching us the entire time while we were filming there.